Well, I'm really liking how everything's coming out. I think this is going to be really cool with these little micro sliders on here. There, I believe it's going to be 33 or 34 of them total, just depending on if I want to keep this X design apparent. Just pay respect to Kobe and his 10th shoe there. But if you can see that little extra white on top of the white, that's just a little piece of paper that I had rubber cemented on the plastic before I started cutting, just so I knew where my lines were, my guide and stuff like that, so I know I could keep this square slash diamond shape as close to that perfect square as possible while sanding it down. But the way I'm looking at this is for every, if you can see the tread on the shoe, for every block of four, so every 16 of these tiny little squares on there, there's only going to be four of those squares actually touching the ice per one. Which, in my opinion, is going to cut the friction down to a quarter on the bottom of these shoes. I think that's going to be pretty cool. But we'll see. I gotta wait till the next summer. The season just ended last week. And it was a good season, but gonna try to make about 10 of these before the Fire and Ice tournament show off. Maybe I'll wear one every end of the game. So I'm just gonna keep putzing on these. Everything turned out real well. If you're ever making your own stuff and you're working with really little pieces, I didn't have any wooden dowels at the house, but I had these longer nails and I just hot glued them to the bottom, and it's been really helpful working with these small pieces on the sander. And if I had a decent router that I could router these on, I could probably do that. The only trick is if you're doing these, when you're letting the glue dry, the hot glue, make sure that it's perfectly level, like the nail is perpendicular to the plastic. It just makes life so much easier if it's perfectly straight when you're sanding it and you're just spinning the nail like straight like it's supposed to be. But if this one's kind of kittywampus, and man, it does not make the shaping of this any easier. So yeah, try to get them as perpendicular as possible. Just checking out the sandpaper. It's wearing down pretty quick. Pretty quickly. I mean, I have plenty. It's just like, it's only been five of these. It's gone through a sheet of paper. Now let's see if I can push it a little bit. Things you gotta do with one sheet of sandpaper. Not that good. Anybody's got any better sanding disc pans out there? Be great. Especially if they're 5-inch, so I don't have to cut them down myself. These were 6-inch, the ones I bought. Couldn't find any. Yeah. Menards. Still watching the rerun of Sweden and Japan. Sweden's up 4-1. Not good. just started before then. Come on.
Sticky bandit.
Ah. Oh, because I'm not using my techniques. Don't worry. Not a good job. All right. going to keep going on these for a while. I'm a little over two-thirds done with everything. Just need to do final sanding. Got 400 grit here. Going to try to get some like 600, 800, maybe even higher if I can. And really polish these guys up. No, literally polish them. Glue them. And then I need to figure out the gripper foot. Then I need to figure out toe cap solution. I'm looking at Kydex material and Kydex formers. Vacuum formers. And then vacuum forming also custom grippers for shoes so they don't have these big bulbousy parts like Ashams have. Just because they have that big disc on their shoes. Cool. Thanks for watching. If you're looking for shoes, come up to Bemidji, the curling club here. I'll probably have a couple shoes there. And if not there, come check us out at curlingkicks.com. All right, bye.